up YouTube? So today we're getting the SS Camaro tuned. I've always been building it for about 2 years now, and hopefully we can see the first pull on the dyno right now. See how it goes. I think we're ready this time, for sure. With this motor, should be hopefully revving up to about 8,000, at least 7.5 for sure. And yeah, everything on this car is like built. Full suspension, transmission's built, the rear end's built. Anything you can think of that's been done to a V8 has been done all motor-wise, for sure. Kind of hands and cam package. A little bit of everything on this car, full bolt-ons. Like I said, it's on E85 too as well. Hoping for a good 500, 600 horsepower, matching torque. Smells so good right now. I wish I would go E85 in my Benz, but E30 is cool for me right now. I think eventually though I will be trying to get a Camaro, like one of these L1s. I like my Benz, but I think it's time to get something different. Been looking for a V8 for a while, so we'll see how this dyno goes and tempted to go V8. So far that's probably like highest has been revved. I think he's just going over the mapping and everything right now until we get the full dyno pull, but so far so good. Hopefully this next pass we'll get a full pass on here. I think we only went to about 3,000 RPMs maybe, so. I think he's gonna do some more adjusting right now, and we'll come back when we're about to get another pull. All right, so he's putting some stickies on the tire so it doesn't spin on the dyno. I'm pretty sure we're about to do a full pull right now, for sure, for sure. Here we go, guys. Hopefully this is it. So that was the first full pull on the Camaro, and sounds really good right now so far. So I think he's gonna be dialing in a little bit more, and start pushing for power. I'm not sure what the dyno he's pushing right now, because that's not the correct number on the actual screen, so we have to ask him. Come back and see what's going on after this. All right, here comes round two. Second pull, sounded good. Thank you. So I think he's doing some more adjusting right now. I'm gonna come back soon as the next pull is ready. Alright, so I think that was like his first real pull. The first two ones were just basic. We'll come back and see what's going on. Alright, so had to get some extra straps on here so we can do another pull. So this ain't gonna rip itself off the dyno. I think this one is going to actually be our first full all-out pull on this car. I think this is the third mapping or whatever that he's done to get it all straight set up. So hopefully this is the one right here. I know I've been saying that this whole video, but this one's the one for sure. So that was the first pull. You can see that was a beast pull. And we can go over everything and see what happened. All right, so this is gonna be the second pass, full pass on this car. All right, so I think we gotta get some more adjustment done, and then we'll come back and see the next pull. Check out this LS7 motor, stage 3 cams, stage 3 head. Really nice setup. Skinny's in the front. Everything built. So far on the run, on a base run, it already did 488 to the wheels. So still got some tuning to do. Hopefully we can hit the 600. So they're gonna do some adjustments right now, then we'll come back. Screaming right now. All right, so we're going for another all-out pull. All right, so the final numbers that we got to pull on this car was 522. Did really good actually, but manifold's a little bit too big for the setup, and the exhaust needs to be a dual exhaust. It's only on a single right now, so that's pretty much it, but car runs perfectly now, and just gotta get an alignment on the thing so we can take it to Irwindale hopefully in the next couple of weeks. So that'll probably be like the second video I'll be doing on this car, so you guys can see, hopefully it can break like a 6 seconds in the 8th mile. Other than that, that's pretty much gonna be it, and see you guys next time.